one of the world's most desirable acoustic guitar brands, have had a makeover. For many years now, Guitar Guitar have been selling Lowden guitars, and they've very much risen to the top of, I think, of most of our staff's favourite acoustic guitar list now, of course. Other big names are in there as well, but when it comes to Lowden, there's something really magical about them, just in terms of how they play, how they sound, and how they react to your playing as well. Anybody who's played one will know exactly what I'm talking about, and if you want to hear it from the man himself, I'm not going to delve too much into the history of Lowden in this video, because you can watch above my head here somewhere, there will be a video. We actually had an interview with George Lowden where he breaks down all of, you know, the history of Lowden, the parts in the series that differentiate from each other. I'll touch on a little bit of this, but today we're going to be talking about the makeover, as I mentioned. Surrounding me are two updates to the Lowden range. We have the 20 series and the 21 series. Now this is the 20 series O in my hands right now. We've got a few others in the other sizes and the other ranges just beside me, which I will play and we can hear how they sound. But in a nutshell, the 20 and the 21 series are replacing the 12 and the 18 series in the Lowden range. And they come in all four of Lowden's catalog sizes. But the biggest difference that we're gonna find between the 20 and the 21, the 20 is a Sick of Spruce mahogany back and sides, obviously all solid, handmade in Ireland, like all of Lowden's guitars. And the 21 series is a walnut and Sick of Spruce top, walnut back and sides, again, handmade in Ireland. Absolutely gorgeous, and they come in the four different sizes. Starting us off, this is the O20, as I mentioned. So the O, to give a slight bit of history, was Lowden's original shape. It's their biggest one they do. As you can see, it's dwarfing me right now, but the sound of that obviously is what everybody's after. I don't mind being absolutely drowned by a guitar for something as good as this sounds. It is quite a thick body on this one. That's one thing to highlight with Lowden's guitars, is that they are ever so slightly deeper than a lot of other acoustic guitars on the market, which, as you're going to hear, gives you that real boomy and projected sound, especially on something as big as this. One of the main things you will hear with an O-type Lowden is, just as mentioned, that kind of boomy and projected sound that it is really going to carry. And I mean, I could strum one chord here. And I mean, I think that still had at least another 15 seconds of sustain there before I cut that off. How rude of me, of course. But the O is great for kind of anything, really. It's what people always assume with these kind of jumbo, bigger size bodies, is that they're only really good for strumming. But with a guitar like this, just and how it's been made and how the wood really complements the body shape, it is just going to project and sound so stunning, even if you are finger picking or playing softer or anything. As mentioned, along with the update to the 12 series, the 18 series has also had an update and a makeover to the 21 series now, which Sick of Spruce top still on that, but it does have a walnut back and sides, as opposed to the mahogany on this here. And that's just this guitar right beside me here. So it's the same big, bold O shape that we all know and love. But with this, the walnut will give it a slightly different kind of sound characteristics. The kind of classic mix of spruce and mahogany has been tried and tested for years, as anybody who is really into acoustic guitars will know. It gives you a really nice, well-balanced tone between the high end of the spruce and then the nice warmness of the mahogany. Now with the walnut, it's not as warm and dark a tone as Mahogany, but it still has a similar sound characteristic. Hopefully it does come through in the video, but do tell me in the comments down below if you can hear the difference between the Mahogany and the Walnut. Obviously, as I mentioned, the O is absolutely perfect for finger picking, strumming, just as your main guitar really for anything, as you will have heard in probably countless records or even just through the Lowden demos. These guitars sound unbelievable recorded, like so good. It's, you know, in the room right now, these guitars sound amazing, but it's really when you hear them properly recorded, and you know, you don't even need to put that much kind of post-production on them. That's how good they are, because they sing just by themselves. Moving away from the O, let's move on to the F series here. Now, this is an F20, Mahogany back and sides, folk style body. Now that you could see more of me as well, you definitely can tell that it's a much smaller body. These are absolutely fantastic, as you would imagine, for finger picking. It's one of the main sort of points. But one thing I always find with acoustics certainly is, you know, one may be a bit more suited to this, a bit more suited to that in terms of technique or in terms of sound. Really, they can translate to anything in terms of whatever you want to throw at them. You know, just because one is technically more suited for that, you may find it perfect for anything that you want to do. But let's give this exactly what it demands, and let's do a little bit of finger picking on it. Obviously, a much smaller body on the F style here is going to maybe suit some people a little bit more than the O style that I was playing. I mean, including myself, I do prefer these much smaller sized acoustic bodies. But one thing to really make note of the F style Lowden is that they do have an extended depth, much like the O style there. So while some other guitars maybe are a bit more high-end when it comes to, obviously frequency-wise, the F Lowden is still going to have a really balanced low-end, as well as, you know, kind of a projecting mid-range as you'd expect from something like this. And I mean, even playing it with a pick as well, it will translate really, really well live or in the studio, much the same as any Lowden, to be fair. Don't worry, I haven't gotten bigger. We're just going down the line. This is the next one in the four models available from Lowden. This is the S, which isn't their smallest, but we're definitely getting into that much smaller parlor, almost kind of travel guitar size, but again, with that Lowden thickness there, which is just really going to give these guitars much more presence and much more EQ than you would expect, obviously, on a guitar of this size. Let's hear how these sound in comparison to the others. We have been stocking Lowden guitars for quite a few years at this point, and with time spent with them, playing them, selling them to people, they are always the absolute showstopper when it comes to putting them in somebody's lap and letting them just play them. There's just, as mentioned, there's just this absolute gorgeous sound that comes from these guitars, and again, I really, really hope it does translate on this video. But if not, that is your excuse to come down and try one, certainly. They are absolutely, they demand to be tried in the flesh so you can properly hear how these sound. But we will move on to our last guitar right now. Last but by no means least, I have the WL21 in my lap here, which is, of course, the wee Lowden 21 walnut backsides and the sickest spruce on here. The wee Lowden more than likely has been seen by yourself in the hands of Ed Sheeran, who not only plays these when he's selling out stadiums around the world, but he does also have his line of Sheeran by Lowden, which is based on this shape, but in a much more obtainable price bracket. With the wee Lowden, of course, much like the other ones, it's a bit of a thicker guitar, but this one is meant to be that tiny little small body that you can play anything on this. It will translate really, really well, but this is for anybody who wants a nice and easy guitar to sit on their lap with, and much the same as the other ones, the 20 series. It's got the mahogany back and sides on it as well, so you can really find the absolute perfect guitar for you. Of course, if you do want more specs on the brand new 20 and 21 line from Lowden, there will be links in the description which will take you right to our website where you can read to your heart's content. And mentioned as well, we do have an interview with George Lowden if you do want to hear from the person who makes them. I think the most important thing with these guitars is, again, which one's going to translate with you, but let us know in the comments, which one would you pick out of these four sizes, out of these wood combinations? Which could you see yourself realistically playing and, you know, absolutely falling in love with? As usual, if you do want to know anything more about Lowden, acoustic guitars, or just any advice in general, do hit us up on our socials on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, TikTok, or get us on our live chat on our website at guitarguitar.co.uk. But I've been Kieran. This is the brand new 20 and 21 series from Lowden, and I hope everybody has a great day.